Hello everyone, I am Jhalak Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication. Welcomes you to the session of Electromagnetic Theory. Today, we are going to discuss about Unit 2, that is Overview of Electrostatics and Steady Magnetic Field with topic Bosonet and Potential. So let's start the session. First of all, let me discuss about the energy expended in a moving charge. Here we consider that the charge is denoted by the capital Q and work done is basically the force applied into the displacement that is done by that particular charge. So force here in this figure, if you see that Fe is our electric force and it has electric field intensity E bar with displacement dl. So we can say that Fe is equal to QE. Even if you compare the equation of force and electric field intensity, then the force equation is our F equal to A Q square upon R square A R bar, and our electric field intensity equation is Q upon R square A R bar. So if you compare these two equations, you can say that force can be get by Q times electric field intensity. That's why here we write F E is equal to Q into E. Here, force applied must be equal and opposite to the direction of applied force. So, it denotes the work done. So, here, force applied is obviously in the opposite direction. So, in the earlier equation, we take plus QE. Because here, the force applied is in the opposite direction. That's why here, we put negative sign, that is minus QE bar, EF bar, where EF bar is the direction. Here, work done can be force applied into displacement. So, minus Q E dl bar. Here, dl bar denotes the displacement in that particular work direction. So, if we take the total work done from some initial point to final point, so we have to do the integration of that particular work. So, it will be minus Q integration from initial to final E bar dot dl bar. Here negative sign is considered because we consider that the charge given is a positive charge. If charge given is a negative charge, then the total work equation will be plus Q integration initial to final point E bar dot dl bar y plus Q, because the force applied should be in the opposite direction. So if we consider the negative charge, then we have to do the work in the positive direction. So this is the final equation for the incremental type work done. So, work done in a loop. Work done in a loop means if we start from some point A and B, at the same point if we end like this. Here, if you see in the figure, the circular path is there. We start at the same point and end at the same point. If we start at the same point and end at the same point, then the integration answer means integration from initial to final point of EDL will become zero. And this gives us zero work done. So that's why we can say that to do a work in a loop, we have the work done zero. Means integration of EDL is equal to zero. This is our second Maxwell equation that we are going to study in unit number 3 also. From this, we can say that the potential difference can be find out. Potential difference between two points, like if point A and B is given and you have to find the potential difference between A and B, then it can be given by VAB. VAB means potential difference between point A and B. It is work done per given charge. Work done per given charge gives us the value of potential difference. Now we have the equation for the work done that we have derived in the last slide. That minus Q integration E dot dl gives us the work done. So minus Q integration E dot dl upon Q. So Q and Q will be cancelled out and this will give us the answer. Minus integration A to B E dot dl. Here if we denote the VEB is potential between A and B, then the upper limit will be point A and lower limit will be point B. If we denote VAB, if we denote VBA, then upper limit is B and lower limit is A. Here, which reference point is taken at an infinite, then we can say that it is an absolute potential, but this equation is for the differential potential. Now, let's see about the potential due to one charge. So potential to point check for that case, we have to consider the electric field intensity due to that particular point charge. So electric field intensity is given by Q upon R square AR bar from this equation. So again we use the potential difference equation, that is minus integration E bar dot dl bar. Now potential difference between point 1 and 2 means V12. So we have to take the upper limit as point 1 and lower limit for the point 2. So minus R1 and R2. R1 is the distance for point 1. R2 is distance for point 2. So now V12 is minus integration R1 R2 E bar dot dl bar. We have already the value of electric field intensity, that is our Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square A R bar. So let's put this in this equation. So the equation will look like this. Here minus integration R1 and R2 Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square A R bar dot dr ar plus r d theta a theta plus r sin theta d phi a phi. Here why we need this type of differential length? Because if you see that 4 pi epsilon 0 r square, 4 pi r square is area of sphere. So that's why this is a spherical coordinate system, and for spherical coordinate system the differential length is dr r d theta and r sin theta d phi. That's why here we take the differential length like this. Now if we do the dot product of this equation, that obviously ER dot ER will become 1, but ER dot A theta and ER dot A phi will become 0. So that's why we can say that these two terms R D theta A theta and R sin theta D phi A phi will become 0 if it multiplied with AR bar. So only term that is remaining is Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square AR bar dot DR AR. But according to dot product, AR dot AR is 1. So the equation will become like this. Minus integration R1 R2 Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square DR. As AR dot AR is only 1, remaining 2 are 0. So the equation is like this. Here in this equation Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is constant. So it is out of the integration, so remaining part is only 1 upon r square. We can write this 1 upon r square as r raised to minus 2. So r raised to minus 2, integration of r raised to minus 2 is r raised to minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1. So the final answer can be like this, minus 1 upon r, but we have to put the limits, that is r1 and r2. So if we solve this equation, the final answer will be Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. This equation can be used for the potential difference between two point charges. If you want only potential at particular point, then it is KQ upon R, means Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R. But if you want the potential difference, you have to subtract this from the another point, that is KQ upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 or R3, whatever the distance given at that particular point. Now let's see one example related to it. The problem statement is two point charges minus 4 microcoulomb and 5 microcoulomb are located at 2 minus 1 3 and the second point is 0 4 minus 2 respectively. Find the potential at 101. Here our desired point where we want the potential is at 101, and two different charges 4 microcoulomb and 5 microcoulomb are located at this type of location, that is 0 4 minus 2, and the another location where minus 4 microcoulomb is located is 2 minus 1 3. So first let's find out the potential. Here for these two different point charges minus 4 microcoulomb and 5 microcoulomb, we have to find out the potential at 101. So we will do one thing, that we find first potential due to minus 4 and then potential due to 5 microcoulomb, and then we add both the potential V1 plus V2. So let's first find 4 minus 4 microcoulomb. As I said earlier that at whatever point we want to find out the potential or either field intensity or force, you have to do one thing for finding out the distance, that is you have to find the distance by the potential required at one point minus the potential where charge is located. So first let's find out the distance, that is R1 means 4 minus 4 microcoulomb. 101 is our point where we desire our potential, and 2 minus 1 and 3 is our point where chart is located. So if you subtract this, you get the answer, that is 1 minus 1, 1 and minus 2. The magnitude of the answer is needed, because in this equation you have to put the magnitude. So minus 1 square plus 1 square plus minus 2 square, that becomes root 6. If you put the second distance, that is for the another charge, that is 5 microcoulomb, and it is located at 0, 4 and minus 2. So that is 101 minus 0, 4 minus 2, again desired point minus point where charge is located. So it will be 1 minus 4 and 3. Now we have two distance. So let's put this in a equation of the potential. So first potential into first charge, that is Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R1. Q1 is given, minus 4 microcoulomb, 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 is root 6, that defined. So answer is minus 14.7 kilovolt. Same way for the second one also we can do. Q upon R2, we have already get the answer for the distance for the second point, that is root 26. So let's put this in this equation. We get the answer, that is 8.83 kilovolt, that is our V2. Now we have both the potential, so total potential is due to addition of both, that is V1 plus V2. So final answer is minus 5.87 kilovolt. Now let's see one another example, that is electric field is expressed by the field intensity vector at up two points M and N. Determine the potential difference between M and N and potential at point N if V is equal to 2 at particular point. Here the electric field intensity equation is given, that is 6x square Ax plus 6y Ay plus 4az volt per meter. So here basically for finding out the potential we need the equation V equal to minus integration E dot dl bar. But in this problem statement, the M and N potential is given. So for that, if you want to find out the potential difference between M and N, so it will be like this, minus integration M to N, E dot dl, here V, M and so upper limit will become M. We have both the points M and N, 2, 6, minus 1 and minus 3, 2. And the equation for the field intensity, that is 6x square Ax plus 6y Ay plus 4az dot dl, dl is our this dx Ax, dy Ay and dz Az. So if you do the dot product, then Ax dot Ax will become 1, Ay Ay 1 and Az Az 1. So the final answer will be like this, only x terms integration, y terms integration and z square integration. If you do the integration, you can get the answer like this. You can solve the simplification and get the answer, that is minus 139 volt for the first case. Now for the end point we have to find. Here potential at the end point is given and you have to find the potential at M point. So we can do one thing, that we can find out the potential difference and then VMN can also be written like VM minus VN. So we have the value of VN. We can find out VMN. So if we subtract VMN minus VN, then we can get the potential at M. So let's do it. Here for point P we have to take. So VNP is VN minus VP. VP is already given, that is 2 volt. So let's find out the potential difference V and P. So minus integration NP E bar dot dl, as we already have the value of E. And differential length. Differential length for the Cartesian system can be written like this, dx Ax, dy Ay and plus dz Az. Okay. So this can be solved like this. So this is how you can get the potential difference between N and T, and you have the potential at N. So you can easily find out the potential at point T, because we have the value of Vp. So Vn can be 19 volt. Okay. Now if you want the potential due to system of charges, if different types of charges are present, then what happens? Then in that case you have to take the differential charge, that is dB equal to dQ upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R. Like this, if line charge is there, then charge distribution can be rho R dl. We have already discussed about this in unit number 1 also. So same concept we have used over here. For the second surface charge, dV is dQ upon 4 pi epsilon 0, but in that case, charges surface charge, so it can be written as rho s d s, where rho s is surface charge density. Same way, if we want volume, then it will be rho v dv for d cube, and it can be written like this, rho v dv upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r. Again, you have to take the integration to finding out the volume. So this is how you can find out different type of charges for the potential. Here, potential due to more than one point charge is according to superposition theorem, it can be find out like V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to Vn. So V1 is basically Q upon R. So Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R1, Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 up to Qn upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Rn. Okay. So up to this, if you have any doubt or query regarding the potential, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you for watching.